Hi everyone. In this product demonstration, we'll be talking about a manufacturing use case which has 30 billion records with line order factory items, 30 billion line order factory items, 30 million customers whom these items have been sold to, supplies information of these items, parts information, and the dates information of each of the transactions. In terms of data size, we will be dealing with some terabytes of data. In the product demonstration, we will look at how we can point to each of these files inside the data lake, then create a relationship among these files, and finally how easily we can design the cube with all the dimensions and measures of a choice. And once that cube has been built, we can look at the BI performance live querying this cube using Tableau and Excel. So with this, I will quickly move to the Kyvos UI. On the screen, you can see I'm inside my Chrome browser and I'm accessing my Kyvos application here. Now, as I mentioned, we have first looked at how we can point to the files inside the data lake, create a relationship among these files, and finally design and build the cube. And once that has been done, we can point to any of our BI tools of choice using the SQL and MDX connectivity and see the performance. So let's get started. On the left, this is the navigation menu. Now we are first looking into the files. These are all my folders that I have access to. And this is the folder where I have kept all the files related to the manufacturing use case. Now I can see the line order, customer, dates, parts, and suppliers that I've already pointed to inside the data lake. Let's look at the customer file. Now here I can see that I've pointed to this file inside the storage layer. In this case, I'm using the AWS instance, and that is why we are pointing to the data inside S3. But we can also point data as a Hive table on top of S3. So you can point to the tables on top of S3, or you can also point to your tables and views inside Snowflake or Amazon Redshift as the data warehouses. Now this is an AWS instance. Apart from this, Kyvos also supports Azure as the cloud data platform, and also Google Cloud as the data platforms. Now in that case, the data storage layer will be the ADLS Gen 2 from where we can source the data, or Databricks as the Delta tables, or you can also, for the Google Cloud, you can point directly the data inside the Google storage, and also BigQuery as the data warehouses. So all those data sources will be supported. Now in this case, as we have pointed to this particular file inside the user SSB customer inside the S3 storage, we can see here this is a CSV type file, but we also support Parquet and sequence formats. So at this stage, there is no data movement that is happening. We are just telling Kyvos that these are the files on the data lake that I want to use for my use case. And we have just pointed to each of these. The next step is creating a relationship among these files. So I will move to the next step. And again, these are my folders. And this is the relationship that I have defined for the manufacturing use case. Now on the screen, you can see there is a line order table, the line order file, which contains those 30 billion records have been kept into the center, and I've related it with each of the dimension files like customer, parts, suppliers, and dates using the particular keys. So the customer key has been used to relate with the customer file, and so on for the others. These can be composite keys also to relate with each of these dimensions. Now with this easy UI, I can drag and drop any other file of my choice and create a relationship. Say I want to drag another customer file here to pull in more customer information. I just drag that file and created a relationship just by drag and drop operation. With this easy UI, I can create as complex schema designs as required. We also support star schema, snowflake schema, or a multi-fact design. In case you have multiple fact tables and multiple dimension tables, you can stitch all of that together using the simple UI. Even if you have a single file containing all the data, you just need to drag it here and create the cube on top of it. So I will revert the changes that I've made here. I'm now on to the last step, that is designing the cube and building it. So at the cube step, these are the folders, and this is the cube that I've defined for this particular use case. Now you can see my cursor here. Onto the right, the relationship that we defined, the star schema in this case, is acting as the source to this. And using that, we have defined all the source fields onto the left. And in the center, I can see the dimensions and measures that I have made part of this cube. So if I look at the customer dimension here, we have created a hierarchy which drills from region to country to city. And there are other detailed data which we have kept into the attributes, like the market segment here. And similar to the customer hierarchies, we have defined the hierarchies and attributes for all the other dimensions like dates, paths, and suppliers. Kaivas provides you with all OLAP functionalities and all set of hierarchies. So you can create unbalanced hierarchies or ragged hierarchies or parent-child recursive hierarchies, and Kaivas should be able to support that. And again, at this step also, it's an easy drag and drop operation to create or design this cube. So on the left, from the source fields, I can select any of these fields and put it across my dimensions and measures. So if I select address and put it across the customer hierarchy, it is part of my hierarchy now. And once this cube has been built, I will actually be able to drill down from the region to country to city and the actual address of the customers. Right. And onto the right are my measure groups. Now here I can look at these different measures like the customer count, retail, wholesale, profit, and all of these measures that we have pulled in from the facts. Let's look at one of the profits as my measure that I've selected. Now here we have the aggregate function selected as sum, but I can choose from any of these aggregate functions like the average count, distinct count, min max, and all of these. And apart from these, we also support calculated measures. So if you have any calculations that you want to incorporate inside the cube, you just need to select this as an expression and write your MDX expressions over here. So if we look at the year over year change percentage, we can look at here that it is comparing the last year profits with the current year and giving us that percentage change. So you can incorporate all the complex calculations inside the single cube layer and then readily access this across your different BI tools like Tableau, MicroStrategy, Power BI, and Excel, and any other BI tool with the SQL MDX connectivity, and leverage the power of single source of truth and also get insights within seconds with all your data. Working with all your data of multiple layers, right? So that's on the measures and dimensions. So on the calculated measures, you can also create any time series calculations like the YTD, MTD, and so on. So you can incorporate all of it inside the single layer. So I will revert the changes. Now, once we are good with the design, whatever we want to incorporate inside the cube, the last step is to build this cube. So I can go to the build option and schedule this. Now for the first time when I'm building the cube, I can take my complete historical data of multiple years inside the full build and submit this job. So it will create all the pre-aggregations on top of all my historical data and store it back onto the storage layer. So in this case, as we are working with the AWS deployment, the cube will be stored back into this S3 layer for this instance. And once this full build has completed, we can set it up for incremental build for the new data that has been coming in. So I can define the recurrence from here, like from a daily, weekly, monthly basis, even on a daily basis. If I want to repeat it in several hours, I can define that recurrence and schedule this. And it will look at the new data that has been created on that frequency and append it to the existing cube of all my historical data. And because we provide live connectivity with any of the BI tools, all your BI users at any given point of time are interacting with the live data that is part of the queue, right? So once this incremental build's complete, the reports and dashboards will reflect that change instantaneously. There is no downtime for the end users. They continue to browse their reports and dashboards on the previous instance. And once this completes, it refreshes instantaneously. So that's on the queue part. There are certain more features like our smart recommendations. So Kaivos provides you recommendations on basis of the queries that have been fired onto the queue. It will give you recommendations on basis of what hierarchical changes you should make, what is the partitioning strategy you should be changing, and so on. So depending on the queries that have been fired to further optimize the queue, it provides you recommendations with its intelligence, right? And you can accept or change these recommendations based on your requirements, right? So that's an AI and ML feature that comes within the product to further optimize the performance of your cube and the single source of truth across different BI tools. Now, another thing is the data security, which is very important for all the big organizations. So we provide row level and column level security built in inside the product. So here you can define the row level, column level security at a group level for the users or at a single user level also. So if we select a particular group, I can define the rules, say on the column level secure or the row level security, I can define that these set of users should only be able to access data to particular regions. And I can either add more rules to this. And similarly, I can define the column level security, like these set of users can say should not be able to see data for particular manufacturer, right? Like for the manufacturing as a column, I can hide it from these set of users. So the row level and column level security you can define at the cube stage itself, and this will be leveraged across BI tools. So when your BI users are logging in with their BI tools with the Kaivos credentials and pointing to this cube, they will only see the data that they have access to and not the complete data. Right. With the security aspect, you can also define which particular cube or object you want to give access to a set of users or a user. So you can grant access from here. You can define the users can have read, write, or you can deny the access, right? And this can be done at each of the steps, like relationships, files, and so on. You can also define roles inside Kaivos. So if I go to the setup step, you can define the roles for like the administrator, business users, or designers, or the end users. You can define role of your choice and give the particular access to the users. Right. So that's on the Kaivos side. In Kaivos, we also provide the Kaivos visualizations. So if the organization or the prospect doesn't have their BI tool, they can use the Kaivos visualizations to create the reports and dashboards here itself. And this comes bundled with the product. So there is no licensing cost based on the users. You can have n number of users come and create these reports inside Kaivos and access them. Right. And similar to the Kaivos dashboards, you can also point to this cube using any of the BI tools, as I mentioned, right? So let's talk about Tableau and now see how we can point to this particular cube and start with the analysis. So I'm inside my Tableau application now, and here I can see in the data source, I have pointed to the same instance, the AWS demo. And here we are using the Kaivos named connector. So here you can go and search for the Kaivos connector, select it, point to the instance and put in your credentials and select this particular queue. In this case, we have selected the manufacturing use case queue here, and we have created a live connectivity. So we are not working with a sample data or extract. We are working with the complete data of 17 years in this cube and those 30 billion records that we had with for those 30 million customers, right? So at any given point of time, when I'm firing the queries from Tableau, these queries will go back to the Kaivos cube and fetches that response. So let's look at one of the dashboard that we have built here on top of the queue. Here I can see the sales overview. Let me go to the presentation view here. So in the sales overview, I can see the KPIs on the left, the customer count, retail, wholesale, and profit information. Onto the top, I can see the region-wise profit distribution. Here I can see how the segments, each of the market segments have been performing. And I can see this across the multiple months of data for all these years. I can drill down at each of these steps. Say I want to look at the data in a particular region. I've selected America. And you can see how quickly all of these KPIs and these measures are reflecting that change and showing data that is only relevant to the America as the region. I can choose from any of these regions that are there. So I can, if I select Asia, and for this also, this reflects data that is only relevant to Asia. I can further drill down to the country level details here. Say if I select India, and further I can drill down to the market segments of my choice. So with this quick analysis, I'm able to drill down at each level and do that multi-dimensional analysis at the speed of thought, working with these 30 billion records and 17 years of data. If I create a new sheet here, I can see my complete semantic layer is available for me to analyze over. So on the left, I can see all these different dimensions, the customer dates, the parts and suppliers, and all these measures that I created over in the Kaivos cube layer are available here. And now I can slice and dice these across to create the visualizations of my choice. I can even see the hierarchies that I created over there. So in the customer, I can see the hierarchy has been maintained, like the region, country, city, and so on for the other dimensions. So let's create a simple report. I will be creating a country-wise profit distribution to start with. So I'm selecting country as one of my dimensions and profit as one of my measure. Now you can see how quickly this is coming up onto the screen. It created a GIS map within seconds, and I can clearly see China and India being the most profitable. I can slice and dice this using any of these other dimensions. So if I select this market segment and put it into the colors, I will be able to see which market segment had been the most performant. So if I change it to a pie chart, I can clearly see the furniture market segment across the globe had been the most performant. So any kind of complex analysis I'm able to do at the speed of thought. And this you can leverage across your BI tools. So let's look at pointing to the same cube using Excel and see the performance, right? So I'm opening Excel blank workbook and I will go to the data here. and from the get data, I will select the analysis services. Now I can select the same URL and I will append it with XMLA Kaivos to create a MDX connection here. And these are my Kaivos credentials. So with these quick steps, I have created a connection with Kaivos, and here I can see all the folders that I have access to. In this was the folder, and this is the cube that we were working with. And we're creating a pivot table report here. I can see all my dimensions and measures have been listed onto the right. I can see all these customer count, profits, and all my calculated measures like the year over year percentage change and whatnot, right? So all my measures have been listed. And again, all my hierarchies for the different dimensions have also been maintained. So I can see the customer, dates, paths, and suppliers. Now here I can create the report of my choice, and let's see the drill down to how we can drill down to each level of detail. So I'm selecting the customer hierarchy to start with. As a measure, I'm selecting the profits. Now onto the left, I can see drilling down to each level of details from the region to the countries to the city level details. And this is all sending a live query to the Kaivos and getting me that response. Let's see this across multiple years of data. So if I select the dates hierarchy, I can see my complete years of data, like the 17 years of data that I have in this cube, and across all these different regions. I can drill down at each level to look at these details. I can further drill down from the country level to the month level and to the day level details and still get this faster performance. And even if I save this Excel, this will be under 1 MB size. So I can share this across my organization and people can sign in with their credentials and access the information that they have access to with the live connectivity with the Kaivos cube. So that is the power that we can bring to any organization working with their complete data of billions and trillions of records, and that too at the speed of thought. That's what I had from this demonstration. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.